very good morning to everyone. Today we are going to start question 5 of the exercise 9L. Okay, in the previous lecture how many questions we have discussed? Till question 4. Okay, question 5 is based upon question 5. 5th to 10th are based upon the word problem questions. You have to understand the statement and then write down in the mathematical form. Okay, and then go with the division or whatever the sign we have given to you. Right? Question 5th is, the product of two numbers are given. So whenever you are having word problem question, please write down the statements also, one to two statements, and then start with the question. Don't write in the beginning with the solution. Product of two numbers are given to you. What is that? -6. Okay, and one number is given to you. One number is given to you, that is -8. Find out the other number. Other number you have to find out. So let's suppose, I'm supposing. Here I have to suppose. Let's suppose the other number, or I can say the second number, will be X. Anything you can suppose. X, Y, Z, A, B, C, M, N, P, anything. Right? Now, what is this? A, T, Q?
According to the question.
According to the question. If I write your A, T, S? According to the statement. Okay, so because we are having the word problem questions, so this thing you have to mention. According to the question or according to the statement. Okay, now question is product of two numbers. You know that product of two numbers I'll write in this way. Here I have to write the first number and second number. Product means? Product means?
Multiply.
And product of two numbers is given to us. What?
-6.
Or -8.
-6.
Okay. What is the first number?
-8.
Should I write -8 here?
Yes, ma'am.
What is second number?
X.
Should I write X here?
Yes.
Okay. Now, how to multiply?
Ma'am, -8.
X will be here. X will be here. Okay. This -6 will be here. This -8 is in multiply with
X.
It is in multiplication. So it will go here in division. Any doubt?
Ma'am.
This
ma'am.
Is the main step only. Yes. Sorry?
-8 will not turn into +8.
No. If you will be having, suppose here you are not having multiply sign. You are having -8 and +x. And here you are having -6. When this -8 will go that side, it will become plus 8. But if it is there in the multiplication, it will go as it is. This sign will change. Multiply will become divide. Okay? Yeah, if here you are having division, that division will become multiply. That sign will be as it is. Okay? In case of multiply and divide, this is the difference only.
Plus,
if you are having plus sign in between, then minus will become plus, plus will become minus. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
Now, x is equals to -6. I have to remove division sign. I have to on 1 or up to 8. You can leave up to here, that is correct. Will mark clear?
Yes.
Girls, boys,
yes,
in the back, clear, sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Now let's start with the next question. 7th and 8th question. Read out the statement once, what they are saying, and then I'll ask you what is the meaning of the statement. Slowly, slowly. Read out the statement. What they're saying? By what rational number should this we have to multiply by this? You get the answer. Okay? Last two boys, I'll ask you. Read out the statement quickly. Therefore, when you are confusing which sign is left here now, by which I have to shift here. So do one thing. You can solve in that method also, but it will be very easy for you. Change the division sign in the beginning. Now it will become multiply. Now shift these two values in the reciprocal form. That's it. This will come here in reciprocal. This will go here in reciprocal and you can select. It will be more easy.
Yes.
You can apply other method also. That will be fine. Okay? But some students were doing with other method. So they were having confusion that after this we have to change in division or in multiplication. Right? So now let's start with the ninth question. Ninth question. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. The ninth question is, in the question 9, please read out the statement. What they are saying in the question? Read out. How many pieces each of length 15 1 by 10 centimeter can be cut from a ribbon of length 181 1 by 5 meter? What is the length of ribbon given to you?
Total length.
Yes, length of total length of ribbon. What is given to you?
181
1 upon 5. Very good. 181 1 upon 5. Can you change this mixed fraction into the fraction?
Yes.
How? 181 multiplied with 5 and add with 1. Please do it. Will you answer? 90655. 90655. Okay. Very good. Now, what else they have given? How many pieces each of length 15 1 by 10 centimeter can be cut? Okay. So, length of each piece. This is length of ribbon and the length of each piece is given.
905
will cut. No. 905 plus 1. Okay. Plus 1. This plus 1 also you have to do. Length of each piece is given how much?
15
1 by 10 meter. Please change into the fraction. Into
one
the power. How much?
151
upon 10 meter. Very good. Okay. Now, they are saying find out the number of pieces. How many pieces you can make? Number of pieces. How many pieces you can make from this ribbon of this much length? So what you have to do?
Total length by the length of
Very good. Total length is 906 upon 5. You divide this length with the length of each piece. 151 upon 10. Any doubt up to here?
No ma'am.
Total length and length of each piece, these both you have to divide. Now what should I do in the first step?
Division.
Yeah, and then the next term will be reciprocal. 10 upon 151. Cancel it. 5 ones are, 5 twos are. Cancel these two.
And it is all 6.
6 tables, take it down on 6 tables. 3 tables, which table?
Take
it down.
6 are,
1, 5, 1, 6 are. 1, 5, 1, let me check. 151, 6 are. 6, 1, 2, 6, 6 are 30. 6, 1, 6, 7, 8, 9. Very good. Will go on 6. Very good. 6 twos are
12
upon 1. It means only 12.
Yes
or no? So how many pieces are possible? There are 12 pieces. There will be 12 pieces we can make from this much length of ribbon. Any doubt? Right? Clear? Last boys? Sure? Girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? Clear? Everyone? Let's start the last question, 10th question. Read out the statement and please tell me what they are saying. Read out slowly, little mark. Last question, that is 10th. 10th question. If 22 dresses of equal size can be stretched from this much meter of cloth, then what is the length of cloth required for each dress? Tell me the length of cloth. You can write total length or length of cloth. How much it is given?
71
1 by 2 meter 142 plus 1, 143 upon 2 meter. You know how to change the mixed fraction into the improper proper fraction?
Yes.
This is improper or proper?
Improper.
Improper, because the denominator is lesser than the numerator. And what is proper fraction? Denominator will be greater than the numerator. Very good. Now, 22 dresses. Number of dresses are?
22.
Yes. Number of dresses that you have to make, that is 22. So, what did you find out? Amount of cloth or length of cloth. Okay, anything you can mention. Amount of cloth required for
22.
One dress. Okay, for each dress, or you can write all one dress. This you have to find out. Okay, so how I can do? 143 by 2. This is the length of the cloth. From this length of cloth, I have to stitch 22 dresses. Yes or no?
Yes.
This is a question only. Okay, from this much cloth, I have to make 22 dresses. So you have to divide it. Okay, now, this is, can I write 1 here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 143 upon 2. Remove division, make it multiplication. It becomes 1 upon 22. Now, please cancel on 11 table.
Yes, ma'am.
11 twos are, 11 ones are, and 11 threes are. Anything else?
No, ma'am.
13 ones are, 13, 2 twos are, 4. So this is the length of cloth of each dress. Okay? This is the amount of cloth for each dress which is required to make. Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Everyone? Understood?
Yes.
Akshya?
Yes, ma'am.
Last girl?
Yes,
ma'am. Sure? So today we have completed the exercise 9F. Okay? Solve the parts which I have given you for the homework. Okay, from question 1 to 4. Whatever parts I have given you for the homework. Okay, rest every question we have solved in the class today. Every word problem questions. So please solve the complete exercise by today in the fair notebook. Right?